Meanwhile, BJP has slammed the West Bengal government and the Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee. They are saying that Mamata Banerjee cannot hide her criminal intent behind the new anti-rape law that has been passed in the West Bengal Assembly. In fact, other than being a desperate attempt to divert attention from the raging anger and the civil society protest against her post the very horrific rape and murder of a young lady doctor at the Arjikard Medical Hospital, a closer look at the fine print of this new anti-rape law reveals that it seeks to limit reporting on judicial proceedings in rape cases. Komolika is with us. Komolika, the West Bengal government has tabled this anti-rape bill. Can you just take us through some of the important provision and you know, this allegation being made by the BJP that it seeks to limit reporting on judicial proceedings, especially in cases of rape?
This is a very interesting political debate which we saw today in the assembly. As we have been reporting for the last 2 days, we had an exclusive access to the content of the anti-rape law. Since day before yesterday, we have been reporting that every rape will be considered as murder. That is one interesting thing. Another interesting aspect is rape. If the victim is alive, even if the victim is alive, if it is a heinous rape which is proved, then life imprisonment, not only 14 years, that has been extended to the life. Life imprisonment, and in case if it is heinous, more heinous, rarest of rare, then capital punishment. Along with that, if the victim dies or in a vegetable state, then in that case life imprisonment and death penalty. In BNS also there are provisions of capital punishment, there are provisions of stringent action. That is what the leader of opposition has said. Mm-hmm. The leader of opposition has said that, well, if this is the point you want to make, protection of woman, BJP is fully supporting the bill, but you have to implement this bill as soon as possible and form the rule. You have to lay down the rule and implement the bill. Now here comes the twist in the story. As this now has been passed unanimously, now it will go to governor, then right, president, then what? Where are the technicalities? And then Trinamool Congress tried to show in the assembly and Mamata Banerjee that Bengal is showing the way, Bengal is making this amendment. It is Bengal who is, who is advocating for capital punishment for this heinous crime. That was the demand of Mamata Banerjee and Abhishek Banerjee. And Mamata Banerjee demanded even the resignation of Prime Minister and Home Minister because they could not protect women as far as Mamata Banerjee is concerned. Shubhendu Adhikari showed that Bengal's law and order is bad. Total, a lot of rapes takes place here. Mamata Banerjee showed that entire country, a lot of rapes takes place in Uttar right. Pradesh and Gujarat and other places.
But you know, I wanted to ask you, Komolika, about the implementation of this. Now, the BJP is saying they're very skeptical about the implementation of this law. How will it really come into effect? Is it true that a separate SIT task force will be formed and that there is going to be a separate court also looking into these, you know, crimes of rape and assault? What really has the Mamata Banerjee government proposed?
See, according to constitution, if there is central law, if there is state law, if state comes up with a law, state can kind of come up with any law. That's what Mamata Banerjee also has kept it in the table. But the point is, if it is contradictory to the central law, then the state law is ultra vires, it ceases to exist. Now what the president will do, whether they will take up, whether that these amendments will be taken up or not, that is a big question, because we have Maharashtra, we have Andhra Pradesh example where such changes were made, but still it is lying with the president.
Yes.
So Mamata Banerjee putting pressure on BJP, saying governor needs to sign, otherwise we will do an andolan. On the other hand, Shubhendu Adhikari knows that practical implication of this bill is difficult. That's why he demanded that you have to implement it immediately and frame the rules. So it is just pushing, both the sides pushing each other. And yes, in this bill there is a special task force called Aparaj Rajita Task Force. A DSP will be looking after all the rape and all the woman-related case. Not only that, there will be special courts also. In that case, the BJP has said that there are already fast-track provision. What have you done with the Nirbhaya fund and all those questions were raised by BJP where they said that they did not do the Trinamool Congress were not serious about that. That's what the BJP is putting pressure, the blame on Mamata Banerjee's side. So it was always pushing and blame game in both the sides, but unanimously state decided that, okay, this law is going to come.
Yes.
State placed it, opposition supported it, but this law practically how, you know, all these things, special courts and as you mentioned, Aparajita Task Force and the infrastructure and everything, if it is passed, if it is finally been taken up, then only all these things comes in. Now that is the big question. Even the name of the Bengal has been changed a long time back, but still it is pending. Now the other Trinamool Congress will say it is the center's decision, it is pending, and the center will say this is only political stunt, nothing more than that. So this is going to be the states, that's what we are getting. And Trinamool Congress now camping with it, that yes, we are the people, we are the state which has brought amendment in this law.
Right, so this anti-rape law aims at fast justice delivery, enhancement of punishment for the accused, at least according to the Chief Minister. And as you were mentioning, Komolika, it's already been passed unanimously. But, you know, there's a lot of skepticism and confusion about how this law will be implemented. Stay on with me. We have the former Chief Minister and senior BJP leader of Madhya Pradesh, Shivraj Singh Chauhan, also giving some remarks on this entire matter. Let's just play that out.